Welcome back. Today we are going to see the next topic in second unit, that is high level data link control. In short, it is called as HDLC. So it is a bit oriented protocol. And it is used for communication over whether you can do it for point to point or multi point. Okay, so we are going to discuss in this topic, we are going to discuss the configuration and transfer modes. The second, we are going to discuss on frames. And third, we are going to discuss on the control field. So these are the three topics we are going to discuss in this video. Okay, first we'll see the transfer modes. HDLC, it provides two transfer modes. One will be normal response mode. Okay. And second is asynchronous balanced mode. So first we will see the transfer mode. In the transfer mode, so it will configuration and transfer mode, it will have two transfer modes. One is normal response mode, other one is asynchronous balanced mode. So we will see one by one. First we will see the normal response mode. In case of normal response mode, it is, in short, it is called as NRM. So this HDLC provides two transfer mode. One is normal response mode, other one is asynchronous balanced mode. First coming to normal response mode. So it is here, the station configuration is unbalanced. It is unbalanced. So we will see the diagram. Then we will see this primary normal response mode. It works like this, like we have primary station and we have secondary station. So in this, what we do is primary station can send the command. This can be used for point to point communication, and secondary station can send the response. Okay, so here it is point to point where we have one sender and one receiver. Primary station is sending for request and secondary station is sending the response. So it is used in this point to point communication. It can also be used in multi-point communication also. So where we have one primary station and then we have multiple secondary station. So in multiple secondary stations, so here the command will be sent like this from the primary station. The response will be given by all the secondary stations. So it is unbalanced over here. Either it can follow, it can be used for this type of mode, can be used for point to point communication, or it can be used for multi point communication. So primary station can send the command and secondary station can only respond. Here it can only send, but secondary station can only respond. So that is called this normal response mode. Next we will see what is asynchronous balanced mode. Okay. Coming to asynchronous. Balanced mode. Here the link is only point to point. It can be used only for point to point communication. So each station can act as a primary station or it can act as a secondary station. So here it is combined. So it can act as a primary station or it can act as the secondary station also. So it is combined station over here. So here this each station can send the command or it can send the response. This station also, it can send the command or it can send the response also. So this is the architecture of asynchronous balanced mode. In asynchronous balanced mode, it is works only for point to point communication, so it is balanced. So we can say it is a balanced mode. So in this, each station can act as both primary or secondary. Either it can able to send the command or send the response. But in case of normal response mode, they can only send, and each station can only send or they can only send the response. Okay, next we will see topic called framing. So the second topic in HDLC is framing. So in framing, this HDLC protocol, it provides three different types of frames. So to provide flexibility, it is providing you three types of frames. That is three types of frames over here. One is information frame. The second one is supervisory frame. And third one is unnumbered frame. So in short, it can be called as I frame, and this is, it's called as S frame, and this one is called U frame. So for sending different types of messages, you can use any of the frame in your packet or in your frame. Okay. This information frame is used for sending user data. It may be a data related with user, like any information data or control information related with the user, we will be using information frame. And supervisory frame, it is used to transport control information. And this unnumbered frame used for system management. So mainly this is a purpose of this particular, all these frames. First we will see this the structure of the frame. The structure of the frame will be, you'll have a flag which is of 1 byte, and then we have an address which is of again 1 byte. Okay, and third we have the control information which is of, which is also 1 byte, and payload information, it is, it may be a variable, the data, and frame control sequence, it is of 2 or 4 bytes, and next is a flag, so this is also 1 byte. So this is a structure of a frame in this protocol. So we are going to see one by one, if the one by one, the frame structure for information frame, supervisory frame, and unnumbered frame. So this is a common structure. So in the common structure, we have a flag which is of 1 byte. That means it is it is having 8 bits, and then we have an address we need to specify, and we need to specify the control information. Then we can specify the data, then frame control sequence that is of 2 or 4 bytes, and at last we have the flag which is of 1 byte. Okay. Now we will see the HDLC frames for I frame, supervisory frame, information frame, supervisory frame, and unnumbered frame. First coming to information frame. In information frame, the structure will be like this. We have a flag, and then we have an address, control information, user information, and then frame, check sequence, and flag we have. Coming to supervisory frame, we have flag, address, control. So we don't have user information, since S frame is used only for control information. So we have frame, check sequence, and flag. Coming to unnumbered frame, we have flag, address, control. So in the case of user information, here you have management information, frame, check sequence, and flag. So here supervisory unnumbered frame is used mainly for system management. So we are going to include management information over here. I frame is used for related with data. So we are including user information. So this is the difference between these, all these frames. So what is a flag over here is, so first the flag, it contains a synchronization pattern. Suppose usually it will be 4, 5, 6. Okay, so it will have an 8-bit pattern. So 0 followed by 6 once and then 0. Okay, so this is the pattern for the flag, which will be available both at the beginning and also it will be at the end. So this is a synchronization pattern which is used for, which can be used as a delimiter for the frame. So it will be, this flag information will be available both at the beginning of the frame and it will also available at the end of the frame. And next we have your address field. Address field contain the address of the secondary station. Suppose if this address, if primary station created this particular frame, if primary station created this particular frame, means it will, this address field will contain two field. So to which station it has to deliver that frame. So it will, this address field will contain two field. If the secondary station has created this particular frame, means then this address field will contain from address. It will contain the from address. So it has to send the reply message to which address. So from address. So this is what your address field. Next on the control field. So next we have your control field. Control field, this is used for mainly for flow or error control. So for this, for checking the error or for doing the flow control, we are having this control field. Next we have your information field. This information field, it will depends, it will vary depending on the type of the frame, whether it is U frame or whether it is I frame, it will vary. So this contains all your user information, or it can be the management information. Okay, this information field. Next we have your FCS. FCS is nothing but frame check sequence. So this frame check sequence will contain information on error detection field. So this is error detection field. So this is used to identify the error happened in the happened in case of your frame. So it will be 2 byte or it can be 4 byte data. Okay, that's all about your HDLC frames. Next we will see the control field format. So here we have the control field. No, so we will see in detail about control field. So this control field have different format for I frame, S frame and U frame. First we will see for I frame. So in I frame, the first bit it will be 0. The first bit is 0. So the first bit in I frame is 0, okay, and the next three bits is called as N of S. So N of S is, next three bits is called as N of S. That means it is going to carry the sequence number of the frame. It is going to carry the sequence number of the frame starting from 0 to 7. So since it is going to start like the 0000010010, something like this. So up to 111. So it is going to carry all the sequence number. So this three bits is used to carry the sequence number. Okay, the last three bits. The last, this is first three, second, next three bits. The last three bits is last three bits is used to carry N of R. That means acknowledgement number. So we are getting the acknowledgement from the receiver, right? So that acknowledgement numbers will be mentioned here. So the I frame, this control field of this I frame contains the first bit will be 0, and the next three bits is called N of S, which carries your sequence number of the frame. The last three bits carries the acknowledgement number of the frame. So it is called N of R. The bit between N of S and N of R, that is called as P or F. P or F. So the bit between, the bit between N of S and N of R, you have a bit that is called P or F. It is called as P or F. If this bit has been set, if the bit is set to 1, if this is set to 1, it is called P, means it is called pole. And if this is set to 0, it is called final. F is nothing but F. F is nothing but final. Okay, what do you mean by this is, P means if the bit is set, so we are going to send the frame from primary station to secondary station. We are going to send the frame from primary to secondary station. That is why the bit is set to 1. If you are going to send the frame from secondary station to primary station, then the bit will be set to 0. That is nothing but it is called final. Okay, so this is all about your control field in your iframe. So it is called the first bit is 0, next 3 bits is used to for sending the sequence number of the frame. Next is P by F field, that is pole or final, which is used to mention whether it is sent, the frame has been sent from primary to secondary or secondary to primary. The last 3 bits is used to represent the sequence number of the particular frame. Okay, so sequence number, no, acknowledgement number of the particular frame. Okay, next we will see about S frame. In the S frame, it is the first bit, it will be the first 2 bits, it will be of the sequence 1 and 0. The compulsorily the first 2 bits will be 1 and 0. This is how we will identify I frame, S frame and U frame. In I frame, the first bit alone it will be 0. Here the first 2 bits it is 1 0. Next, the last 3 bits, as in case of I frame, here also it is called, it is used to represent your acknowledgement. So the first bit is, first 2 bits, first and second bit will be 1 0, and the last 3 bits it is N of R, which represent the acknowledgement, which is used to represent the acknowledgement. And then here you have your P by F, the same thing, it is P by F, which is used to middle bit, 5th bit is used to represent your P by F, that is used to tell whether it is polling or it is final. That means whether you are going to send the information from primary to secondary or you are going to send the information from secondary to primary. Now we are going to see the middle 2 bits, that is 3rd bit and 4th bit. So 3rd bit and 4th bit, it will have the code, it is called as code. The name given for this 3rd and 4th bit is called as code. Okay, it will be having 2 bits. So here in this, it can be of 4 types. The first thing is, first it can be called receive ready. So receive ready will have the code 00. Okay, the next one is receive not ready. So it will have the code 10. And third is reject. So reject, it will have the code 01. And fourth is select to reject will have the code 11. So this code will have these 4 forms. Either it can be 00, or it can be 10, or 01, or 11. So if the code is 00, means it is, the machine is ready to receive the frame. And the next is, if it is 10, means it is not ready. And 01 is, it is some frames has been lost, so it is going to reject it. So 01. And selective reject is, it is going to reject some acknowledgement frame, or selectively it is going to reject some of the frames. That is called selective reject. So it is called 11. So this S frame contains the first 2 bits is 10, next 2 bit is called code, and 5th bit is P by F, which represent pole or final. The last 3 bits represent your sequence number. Okay, so the code can have 2 bits, either it may be 00, 01, 10, or 11. Okay, now we will see the control field for U frame. So control field for the U frame, it is also having the first bit, the first 2 bits, it will be 11. Okay, and next 2 bits, it is called as code, and the 5th bit is called pole or final, which is going to represent whether you are going to send the frame from primary to secondary or secondary to primary. The last 3 bits, it is called as N of R, it is used for sequence number, it is used for representing the sequence number. So now here in the U frame, this code 2 bits and N of R, it can be represented in this format. So code, it is having 2 bits, and N of R, it is having 3 bits. So if the code bit is 00 and N of R value is 001, here we have the value 001, it is used for normal response mode. We are going to send that frame in normal response mode. If the code is 11 and N of R is 011, it means that we are going to send it in normal response mode extended format. Okay, so now when the code, it is in 11, and when N of R value is 100, we are going to use asynchronous balance mode for sending this. When it is 11110, it is asynchronous balanced mode extended. And when the value is 00111, it is unnumbered information. When it is 00 and 110, it is unnumbered acknowledgement. When it is 0, 0 and 0, 1, 0, it is disconnect. So we are going to discard that particular frame. So this is what the codes we have. We will see the example, then you will understood what is this codes means. Okay. So the first two bits, it will be 1, 1 in case of your 1, 1, it is in U frame. And the next bit, it will be, a code value. And then the fifth bit is for P by F. And the last three bits is N by R. Okay. Now we will see an example for this U frame. This shows a U frame can be used for connection establishment and connection release. So the node A is asking for a connection to set an asynchronous balanced mode, and node B gives a positive response with an acknowledgement with unnumbered acknowledgement frame. Then after these two exchanges, data can be transferred between two nodes. After data transfer, node A sends a disconnect to release the connection. It is also confirmed by node B responding with unnumbered acknowledgement. So for this, we will see the U frame. So node A and node B is there. First, node A is asking for connection establishment with U frame. So in this frame, we'll have a flag information. And then we have the address information. Since node A is sending to node B, so it will have B address over here. And this is the control information. And then we have management information, management data, and frame check sequence. At last, we have the flag. So coming to control information, so it is the control U frame. It is having the first two codes will be 11. The next code is, since here we need to establish the connection using asynchronous balance mode. So the value for this is 11100. So 11100. So here we are sending 11 over here, and then we have with the P or F frame. At last we have 1100. So this is for establishing the asynchronous balanced mode. So after establishing the mode, asynchronous balanced mode connection, the node B sends an acknowledgement. So here it is sending the flag information, and the address will be A. So B is sending the information to node A. So we are writing A over here, and then control information. Other things, it will be the same. You'll have management data and frame check sequence, and we'll have the flag. So the control information for U frame is first two bits, it will be 11. And afterwards, now it is going to send a acknowledgement. So unnumbered acknowledgement. So here for this, if you go and see in this unnumbered acknowledgement, it is 00110 is for unnumbered acknowledgement. So we are going to send 00, and then this is P or F. This one is 1100. Okay, so next, after this establishment, data will be transferred. Now again, connection, if after transferring the data, we need to release the connection. So for this, A wants to send a release connection to node B. So first it is sending a flag information. Now it is connecting with B. So now again, this is the control information, management data, and we have frame check sequence, and at last we have the flag. So the first two bits is 11 over here. Now this is used for disconnecting the frame. For disconnecting the frame, so if you see disconnection, it is for disconnecting, we have 00010 is the code for this. So what we write is 00 over here and 010. So this is the frame for disconnecting. Now we have to send the acknowledgement for this unnumbered acknowledgement. So again, the flag is sending. So it is sending to A. So it is control information. Now it is control. So other things are same, management data. Then we have frame check sequence, and we have the flag. So now we will see the first two codes is 11. Now it has to send the acknowledgement back to this one. So it is acknowledgement value 00110 is for sending acknowledgement. So it is going to send 00110. So this is the example where we have used. So if you see this is an example where we have used U frame for making a connection from A to B. First, it is asking for asynchronous mode connection, and then B is sending a frame for sending the acknowledgement. After that, we are going to do the data transfer, and now we are going to release the connection. After sending it, if you want to disconnect the connection, it is going to release the connection with this codes, and this acknowledgement will be given by this set of codes. So in this example, in this video, we have seen all the U-frames, and also we have seen HDLC protocol, that is HDLC protocol configuration and transfer modes, and we have seen on framing. The framing for three different framings, we have seen I-frame, S-frame and U-frame, and at last we have seen the controlled field information for all these three frames and with an example. Okay, thank you.